The Port of Hamburg achieved stable throughput numbers compared to the previous year. The balance presented by the Board of Directors of Hamburg Port Marketing, together with the Minister of the Economy Frank Horch and Jens Meyer, CEO of Hamburg Port Authority, showed at 136.5 million tons a slight decrease in container handling numbers. When we look at the absolute numbers, there seems to be some stagnation, which doesn't surprise me. This is caused by certain events. There is strong competition, in example the Port of Rotterdam, who opened a new terminal. There are the new alliances. In this situation, to achieve nearly the same result as the previous year is good. I think we can be content enough considering that we haven't done the adaptation of the shipping channels. The number of full containers stayed stable. There is a decline in empty container handling. And with the feeder containers, which don't have to be routed through Hamburg, there is also a slight decline. One reason for this, the already mentioned necessary adaptation of shipping channels. However, unaffected by this, there was a record result in another area to celebrate by Port of Hamburg. This is in bulk materials, materials that are processed by grabbers such as coal or ore. Both areas with the best result ever achieved in Port of Hamburg. 23.5 million tons together. That is a top result. Such top results should be possible for the stagnating areas too, if there was finally a go-ahead for the project adaptation of shipping channels. If we get the positive message that the adaptation of shipping channels is finally put through and coming, then I will be very happy for 2018 already. Then we can work with this message and approach customers and markets. The actual work on the adaptation of the channels, widening and deepening, will most probably only start in 2019. However, already started is another project to get the port ready for future challenges. At Port of Hamburg, we are already leader for many years with our smart port project, also in many logistically and digitally controlled processes. And now we got the chance, with support of the European Union, to test the new standard 5th generation cellular network technology. And we will try to apply this extremely fast and secure network successfully at Port of Hamburg, to optimize traffic light controls, to intelligent traffic-dependent control systems. It's moving ahead with the concept of Port 4.0 and the digitalization and thereby optimization and modernization. The outlook for the coming year is positive. Well, I am expecting the final decision on adaptation of shipping channels. This is most important for us. Well, I am hoping that we will keep the level we are at right now. We will keep working on infrastructural projects. We are in the process of building the Katwijk Bridge for rail cars. This will mean an additional crossing in the context of unbundling of traffic flows. And we are, of course, planning a future Kühlbrand crossing. This will require the decision of a century. Will it be a bridge crossing? And if, at which height? Or is it going to be a tunnel solution? 2018 is setting a direction for the future development of the Port of Hamburg and holds more than one extremely important decision process, like for example on the adaptation of shipping channels or on the new regulation of import turnover tax, that are of a great relevance for the future.